Hello again. Let's talk to Larry Bottomley, CEO of Chariot Oil and Gas. Larry, I've spoken to lots of people in many exotic locations today, but you're just around the corner from me in Piccadilly. Welcome to Proactive Investors London. Let's talk then about your offshore license off Morocco, the Lixus license. What's the detail on that?
We signed the Lixus license yesterday. It's a almost 2,500 square kilometre block, and it's just to the north of our current licenses, Mohammedia, Kenitra. And this license has seen previous expiration. There are three legacy 3D surveys within the block, and there are four historic wells, and one of those wells is a discovery. That's the ONHYM-1 well, and that encountered 55 metres of net gas pay in very high quality rock. What we've been able to do is to undertake a description of that asset, and Netherland, Sewell have completed a competent person's report, and they assign 307 BCF in the discovered reservoirs within that well. There were two sands, the A sand and the B sand, and they contain this 307 BCF. Just because of the nature of the discovery, there's a deeper sand that wasn't penetrated by the well. It was off to the side of that well, and that's got an additional 116 BCF that sit within it. So within the ONHYM discovery, the combined remaining recoverable resource is 423 BCF. That's an equivalent to a 70 million barrel oil equivalent discovery. And of course, it's gas, and Morocco has a very dramatic growing energy position. It is gas hungry, imports gas from Algeria currently through the MEG pipeline, and gas prices range between $9 and $10.50 per MCF. So the combination of the resource size that we've secured by acquiring this license, and the market conditions, we see this as being a potential significant appraisal development campaign on that asset. So something we're very excited by.
So you've got your CPR then. What other further appraisal steps will you make? And what then will you do to develop the asset?
Well, we've been very fortunate in that we've secured this license with the discovery with a very low work program commitment. It's essentially a reprocessing campaign of the seismic data that exists on the block. So these legacy 3D surveys. So we've initiated the reprocessing of those. But the principal activity is being able to fully describe this asset so we can take it through appraisal and development. So firstly, we've undertaken a feasibility study. This is with upstream advisors, a group of engineering consultants, and they're looking at a number of potential development schemes, and we'll be able to work those development schemes through to a costing so we can understand that aspect of it. Secondly, while we've got an understanding of the gas market within Morocco, clearly there are a number of players that we will be dealing with. So we have Gas Strategies, a consultancy that does what their name suggests, and they are undertaking a detailed review of the gas market in Morocco and where we can be allocating the resource that comes from that. And then finally, the CPR that we've done is on ONHYM itself, the discovery, but there are a series of satellites that surround ONHYM. A CPR has been completed on three of those satellites. There's an additional two satellites, but those five satellites between them add up to in the region of 500 BCF. So ONHYM and its satellites could be in excess of 900 BCF. So we're also completing the CPR of ONHYM and its satellites. And then finally, within the block, there are additional five prospects in the eastern part of the block in the same play system that appear to have the same characteristics. We are completing our technical description of those, and they will also go to Netherland, Sewell for CPR. So it'll be the reprocessing campaign, the feasibility study, the gas market study and analysis, and then the combination of that to take us through how we might potentially appraise and develop the program.
And picking up on the point you made about strategy, if we can say broad view for a second, how does this new license fit into the broader asset portfolio?
Right. Well, one of the important things about our historic portfolio is that we have been focused on giant potential gas and oil opportunities. So we've been elephant hunting. We've been looking for the giant fields, and we've built a portfolio of those types of assets in Brazil, Morocco, and Namibia. But what this allows us now to do is to combine with those giant scale opportunities, discovered resources where the technical risk has been taken away, low risk exploration opportunities that have the potential to tie back to that, low risk exploration opportunities within the block that could be on a standalone basis, and then the higher risk opportunities that we have in the giant portfolio. So we've significantly broadened the risk profile of the company, but also we've now got assets that go all the way from appraisal through to wildcat to exploration. So, and that totally fits within our strategy of trying to create transformational value, which is what we would do if any of these parts of the portfolio were able to deliver.
Ticks in all the boxes, Larry. You certainly look a very happy man at the moment. Don't blame you by the sounds of it. But in terms of news flows over the next few quarters, what can investors expect to hear from you in terms of developments?
Well, firstly, we've got the work associated with the Lixus offshore license. We've got the CPR projects that are undergoing. So we'll have a better description of ONHYM shortly, and then the rest of the portfolio. The feasibility study, that will be put together within the next couple of months, and we'll be able to describe how we might potentially develop the asset. And then we'll also have a better, more detailed understanding of the gas market. So over the next 2 to 3 months, we'll be able to have a lot clearer vision on how we take the asset from where it is to where it can be, so we can deliver that value to the shareholders. Separately, on our portfolio, we're looking to partner. We will be looking to partner within this Lixus offshore license, but in our other licenses in Morocco and our Brazil and Namibian licenses, we will be looking to partner on those. So the partner program and process with those is ongoing. Our ongoing discussions are underway, and we'll announce those as we can.
A great update. Come back and tell us more soon when you've got news flows. But for the moment, Larry Bottomley, thank you very much indeed.
No, thank you.